Hi guys, welcome to my first video of my attempts at cooking something healthful and delicious. I'm Eric and this is my kitchen. I've got a bit of vegetables to work with that I found in my refrigerator. I'm going to try to use all of these up. And over here I've got some water boiling. And we'll use that in just a couple minutes. So here I've got broccoli. I've got some acorn squash, delicious. Some red peppers. Some sweet peppers here. I don't know if you can see that, but I just cut the stems off of them because I'm going to use them with these. Green peppers, which I got in a bag. They're already cut, and I think they're mostly, they should be a quick blanch for those. So just a couple minutes in this boiling water over here, and I'll blanch those. I'm going to make a salad out of these two with some garlic and some vinegar and maybe some onions. So back to the vegetables, and my green onions. I've got a sweet onion here and some sad looking tomatoes. Not sure I'm going to use those, but maybe I can do something with that. And then here is some fresh cilantro. You can get fresh cilantro about any time of year, and it's really a good addition to just about any dish you can make. But some people don't like the taste. I love it. I think it enhances the flavor of any dish that I create. So give me a few minutes. I'll be back. I'll show you some of the steps that I go through. And then at the end, we'll have a great meal. So, got a lot of vegetables to work with. A little bit of this. And I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so I'm going to cut up some garlic now. Mincing is making the garlic into... actually, I don't remember what they are. That's dicing. I had to look up what mincing is, but I know what it should look like, so we'll see if I can come up with some minced garlic here. It says about a tablespoonful, and this is a tablespoon, so it looks like I have just about a tablespoonful. I'm not going to put it in there. I don't use recipes a lot, but I did find this on the bag of the these green beans. So I'm going to follow that because I don't know the proportions to use for this. So if I had an idea about the proportions to use, I probably would just eyeball it. But in this case, I'm going to take their recommendations and use about a tablespoon of minced garlic. So the water has been boiling for a little bit, and I'm just going to blanch these, which is just a couple minutes in boiling water. I'll get my beans here. Let them soak just for a minute. Push them down with to cover them and let them come to a boil for about 3 minutes here. The water is pretty hot. I know it's cooled off a little bit with the with putting the cold beans in there. I'm going to set the timer for about 3 minutes. That should be enough to soften them up enough. So when that goes off, we'll be I'll set those aside. Sorry, it's just my chest talking right here. So I've measured out a quarter cup of apple cider vinegar. I've got a tablespoon of minced garlic. I'm going to put some olive oil in it, which calls for about a tablespoon, but I like a little bit more olive oil. And the sweet peppers, I'm going to combine that into a bowl. Let that sit for a while because it's supposed to be at room temperature. I'll probably add some of the cilantro. Fresh cilantro always makes a salad taste good. And again, I'll probably put some of my green onions in here, so watch for that in a moment. Beans are done. I've taken them out of the boiling water and I've placed them to cool off in the dish that I'm going to serve them in. So I'll let them cool down for a little bit before I add the other ingredients, which is going to be the vinegar and the garlic, and then that'll give me a little bit of time to chop some onions. Let's move the vinegar out of the way and keep the garlic on the board here, and we'll cut up some of these onions to add to the salad. So just get rid of some of the tops here. I'll do my best at cutting these. I don't really care if they're going to be in bigger chunks, so I kind of want them in large chunks. You can make them smaller, but I don't want them to be regular sized, and so I'm kind of cutting them haphazardly here. Let's see how the beans are doing. Yeah, the beans are nice and cool. Well, they're room temperature now. All right, so I've got my green beans here. I've got the onions and garlic, and I've got olive oil. Put some olive oil, some vinegar, and calls for a tablespoon of olive oil, but I'm going to, again, do that by taste. That smells good. And here's the sweet peppers I'm going to add to it. Let's move that into the view there. I'm probably going to put this into a mixing bowl since it's I think it's too small. And then I'll transfer them back. What am I missing? I'm missing something. Oh, salt and pepper. Some pepper. And some salt. This has got a nice colorful texture, colorful look. Smells great. I can smell the vinegar, smell the garlic. And I think if you let that sit for a little bit, it'll be just wonderful. At the very end, I'm going to put some of the cilantro into it. I think keeping it as fresh as possible helps with the flavor right when you eat it, rather than mixing it in. Okay, so I've transferred from my mixing bowl into the serving bowl. Probably do a little last minute mixing here to make sure it looks and tastes good. I could probably use some more peppers in here, but I'm going to leave it as is. I think it'll be fine. I'm going to put just a little bit more of the olive oil and vinegar mix into here. Get all those little chunks of garlic. That adds so much flavor to it. I've transferred all my ingredients for my salad into a bowl that I'm going to just let sit. The vinegar and the garlic should mix pretty well. I put some sweet peppers in there. The green beans, of course. I chopped up some green onions. There's garlic, as I said, and salt and pepper. So we're just going to leave that sit for, I don't know, about 20 minutes or so as I prepare the other parts of the meal. I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do with all of these yet, so I do know what I'm going to do with the acorn squash. If you haven't had acorn squash, it is one of the most versatile squashes out there. You can do so much with it. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to half it, and then I'm going to seed it, so each half will have this nice pocket into which I'm going to put butter and brown sugar. I'm going to cover the halves, each half, with saran wrap, and cook it in the microwave at high temperature for 3.5 minutes, and let it sit for a minute, and then I'm going to cook it for another 3.5 minutes, same high power setting. My microwave is a little bit older, so it may not take 3.5 minutes for you for just an average size acorn squash, but you'll have to experiment to see what actually works. For me, it's about 7 minutes total. For the other ingredients, I'm not sure yet. I am thinking about maybe I'll cut these in half and put them on the grill. Maybe I'll julienne them and put them in to saute them, which I have the skillet set up already for that. Or I could just dice them with some broccoli and the sweet onion, maybe a little bit of garlic, and use a wok. I could stir fry them. So I have to decide yet what I'm going to do with the rest of the vegetables. I think I'm forgetting something. Oh, I do have some bread. I've got a product from a neighborhood farmer's market. It's called Take and Bake, and it's a garlic loaf. And this is really good, and it's a good, fast way of making good-tasting bread that you don't actually have to go through all the kneading and working with dough and all of that. So it's actually pretty good, and it's as close to home baked as I've had without buying home baked or making it myself. So it's called Take and Bake. So I'm gonna put this in the oven for about 10 minutes at 380 degrees. That'll come out really nice and warm. So I'm gonna wait till the very last to do that. So the last 10 minutes of the meal prep is when I'm gonna put this in. So let me think about what I'm going to do with these the vegetables, and I'll be back. I'm about halfway through the jigger of Jack Daniels, so let's see how the meal's progressing here. Not very well, I must say. I don't have a whole lot prepared yet, and I don't care. I think everybody should cook with alcohol, in you. Here's my lovely salad. That's the most accomplishment I made, and I did the dishes. So here's the skillet. I'm going to put some olive oil in it. I'm going to julienne. I don't think that it's truly julienne. I'm going to strip, cut these lovely peppers into strips. I'm going to cut the onion into about equal size strips and saute them. So I'll cook them with for about 10 minutes, I think, 8 to 10 minutes, something like that. It's about all it needs. Softens them up, gives them a little, just enough crispness so that the onions and the peppers taste good together. So far, my prep time has been about 15 minutes. Boiling the water took the longest, which is about 20 minutes. So I set that on the stove while I did all the other things. But preparing the vegetables and all of that, that only took about 10 minutes or so. So I'm still trying to figure out what I'm going to do with this. Don't know yet. This will just be more of a garnish, and it enhances the flavors of the salad. Maybe I'll put that in with the peppers and onions. So I'm going to do peppers and onions, broccoli somehow. I'm going to do the acorn squash in the microwave with some butter and brown sugar. And then I've got a salad already made, and then going to make the take and bake bread. So there's a commercial for that. So the one thing I left out is I'm thinking about I'm going to want something like cheese or some type of protein with the meal, but I'm going to use brie, and I'm going to melt brie over the bread. I think I'm going to toast the bread a bit. So I'll maybe do that in the oven. So still thinking about it as I'm putting together what I'm going to do. I'm usually not this unorganized with the kitchen, but it's just me, so I don't really care. So I got no time pressures. But the whole meal should take about 30 minutes to prepare is what I'm thinking. Okay, be back in a minute. I'm putting this in the oven with some cheese so it'll I don't have to do it ahead of time. I thought I was going to, right at the time the meal served. So here's the instructions. It says preheat the conventional oven to 385 degrees. Preheat. I don't know about you. I have an issue with this term, preheat. You either heat or you don't heat. Preheating is all the steps you do to get up to heating. Like I'm walking over to the oven right now. That's preheating. I'm going to hit the button. That's preheating. And I'm going to hit start. That's preheating. So I'm preheating. It's at 385. Can you see it? 385. The glare is a bit much. But now I'm going to put the bread in the oven. And it says just to put it on the rack. So I don't have to put it under on a... I don't have to... Where should I look? So I don't have to dirty another pan. So you guys who just hate to do dishes, no pan. All right, so here we go. Taking it out of the bag, putting it in the oven at 385, which is preheated. I'm gonna set it for about 10 minutes and hit start. Okay, so I'll come back in a couple minutes and check on that just to make sure I'm not overcooking it. I don't like burned bread. But what I plan on doing is maybe, using that bread, slicing it, putting some pieces of brie on it, putting it back in the oven to brown it a little bit and melt the cheese, and then some of the sauteed vegetables that I'm making now. I'm going to put it on top of the bread with the cheese. I think this is gonna be really good. This just came to my mind. I don't really know, but I'm thinking that might be a good combination. So we'll see. So I'm gonna pause here and then I'm gonna do all of that and I'll be back. I'm eating the broccoli raw. And I'm thinking I'm going to combine that with the beans and the peppers. I think it might be good. Since I haven't had the beans and the peppers yet, maybe I won't. So let's give it a taste. So I'm going to try maybe a little pepper and some beans here and see how it goes. So, all right, here we go. So I got some of the garlic and definitely taste the olive oil. A little bit of vinegar, just the right combination. I must say, whoever put that recipe together did a good job. So I think the broccoli is going to taste good with this. So I'm just going to cut the broccoli up a little bit smaller than what I have now. I just basically took the stalks off of it. It'll be good deer food. Some leftover bad basil. So I'm gonna cut this up a little bit smaller and I'm gonna combine it with the blanched beans and peppers and see how that goes. I think it's gonna be good. It actually has good flavor to it already. I think the crunchiness in the and the sulfur salty flavor, this flavor of the broccoli is gonna match well with the beans. So there's that. A little bit more. Okay, that should be enough cilantro. That looks like a really good salad. I think I lost some of my cilantro down on the floor there. All right, so I think what I've decided to do is cut the peppers into strips, cut the sweet onion into strips, saute those while I'm cooking the acorn squash in the microwave. And so both will take about 10 minutes or so. I'm going to prepare the peppers first, get them underway, then I'm going to prepare the squash and get that underway. So that should, the timing should be about right. The bread's got another 2 minutes or so to go, so that'll be done. I'll set that aside and then I'll slice it and I'll cut those into slices and put some bread with cheese on it, some brie cheese. So that will provide some of the protein for the meal. Okay, so I'm going to cut the peppers. Sometimes what I like to do is to maybe cut the stems off of the peppers, just like this. And then take a knife and cut them right in half. Right like that. So then you've got this nice looking pepper cut in half. You can gut it so that all the pith is taken out. And then put this on the grill. And you can put all sorts of ingredients in there, either on the grill when you're cooking it, or make the ingredients separate and then combine it at the time that you serve it. So, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut these into strips. There, my bread's done. So let's get the bread before I do that. I need something to put it on, aren't I? So let's get something out of my collection here. Okay. What can I pick it up with? I don't know what I'm going to pick it up with yet. So let me try this. I'll try setting this up so you guys can see what I'm doing. Here's a cutting board, and I'm just going to slide the bread. Yes, I think that's it. All right, so the bread is done. I'm going to turn off the oven and the timer. I'm just going to leave this sit here for a few minutes. There's no reason to work on it right now. It's too hot to slice, so I'm going to let it cool down to room temperature, and then I'll slice it at that time. And I'm going to put it back in the oven. So, I should leave the oven on. I'm going to set it to broil. So the oven's going to broil now, and then I'll come back in a few minutes, and I'll slice some brie up, and then put that together. So right now what I'm doing is let's complete this process of getting the preparing the peppers here. So we'll get rid of all this pith that's in here. I've taken the bread and the brie out. I've put it to cool. It looks like the brie is melted properly over the most of the bread. Now I'm going to try to remove the wrap from the peppers. One thing I've learned is taking the saran wrap off of the acorn squash. It is so hot, and the steam comes shooting out of whatever you open, so just be careful. Believe me, it's not pleasant. So let's see if I can do it successfully here. I'm just peeling that back. So I peeled back the first plastic wrap. I think I'm gonna leave this one on because I'm not gonna eat this one tonight. I'll maybe have that for lunch tomorrow. But you can see that the brown sugar and the butter has melted so nicely together, and it tastes just wonderful. It's got a nice sweet flavor, and I would recommend using a fork, and you sort of mix it together when you cut the acorn squash with the fork. I'm gonna let that cool off because it's really too hot to eat right now. And then what do we have left? I've got the bread with the brie. I've got the peppers and onions. I've got two salads, just a regular cold salad, and then we've got green bean salad with sweet peppers. I can't think of anything else I'm missing. So I'm gonna prepare the plate. Normally I would have wine with dinner, but because I've had so much bourbon, I am not going to do that. I'm just gonna have bourbon. So peppers, sweet acorn squash. Oh, one thing I forgot. I'm going to put nutmeg on the rim of the acorn squash. It's just a nice little flavor enhancement. I like to add it. Some people don't like the nutmeg. You can use cinnamon. You can use more brown sugar. Just leave it alone. So let me grab that. I'll move over to that area and then prepare the plate. Okay, so I'm going to put a little bit of nutmeg on the rim of the acorn squash. Here's the ground nutmeg. So that gives a little bit of sweetness too. I've seen people use allspice and cinnamon. So nutmeg is my choice here. So I'm going to do that. So you can see that nice melted butter and brown sugar mix. I don't like too much nutmeg. That is really a pungent spice, so be careful with that. That's enough for me. Okay, I'm going to try to move this over to my plate here. So, perfect. Okay. Wow, that was hot. Okay, so now let's move over. So I'm going to prepare the plate. I've already put the squash on, so I don't know if you can see that. The squash is well done. I'm going to grab brie and bread. These are essential in your kitchen. So when you're cooking, you need a couple of these. So I'm going to use some hot peppers. They're not hot. I'm sorry. They're sweet peppers. They're hot from the skillet, and I'm going to cover the bread and brie with it. So I've got the two hot ingredients. Now I'm going to go for the two cold. So here's my bean and pepper salad. So that's kind of the cold ingredients. Okay, so I finished cooking. I think total time is about 40 minutes. I underestimated the amount of time it would take, but so 40 minutes from prep to plate. I think I did okay with this. Here's the salad. Put some olive oil and vinegar there. I've got my acorn squash with brown sugar and butter. I've got a bean salad, which I'm going to try. I haven't had this before, so I'll be interested to see what it tastes like. And I've got the peppers, sauteed red peppers with onions over bake and bake bread with brie. We'll see how that goes. I haven't had that before. And so there's no meat here, but there is some butter. So it may not be as healthful as I intended, but a tablespoon of butter, maybe not as bad as like a whole steak or something. But anyway, I tried to be healthful. I tried to be helpful in showing you what I do to prepare my dinner. This is what it looks like. So I couldn't help remarking on how this tastes. It was the first time I had the blanched beans with vinegar and olive oil and sweet peppers. And it's wonderful. I'd have it again. I had regular salad, which that's nothing special. But I'm going to try the peppers with the bread and brie and see how that goes. Again, not something I've prepared before. So it'll be interesting to see what the flavor's like. Maybe I'll like it, maybe I won't. So here we've got some peppers, onion, bread, melted brie. Surprisingly good. Yeah, that's a good combination. So the softness and crunchiness of the bread, the softness inside, the crunchiness outside, mixed with that sweet, pungent flavor of the brie. And then that wonderful combination of onions and peppers together. Just a little bit of salt and pepper. Wonderful. I'd recommend doing it. I've not done this before. I never saw that recipe, but it looked like a good idea. Sounded like a good idea, and it tastes really good. So I'll probably do this again. So what I do is I use a fork instead of a spoon, and I pull away the flesh from the edges, and I mix it with the sauce, so to speak, the butter and brown sugar. And as you mix it, it sort of cools off too, so it's easier to eat. And this has been sitting for about 5 minutes, so it should have cooled off a bit, but you can, I don't know if you can still see the steam coming off of it, it's still pretty hot. So I'm not gonna attempt this yet, but it looks like exactly what it should. This nice, almost a pudding consistency. So if you've cooked it right, it should be soft to the fork. So it should peel away from the sides of the rind, and you can mix it with the butter, the melted butter and the brown sugar. And that gives us this nice, sweet, buttery flavor. The squash itself has a nice flavor to it. It will absorb just about anything you mix with it. But this sweetness and the butteriness is really, it suits it well. So you can see that almost has a pudding consistency or maybe a pie consistency. It is really good. Okay, so I'm about to try the acorn squash with the butter and brown sugar. It is still really hot, so I'm going to have to let this cool off a bit before it hits my tongue. I don't know if you can see that, but it's got this fibery texture to it. It's really good when you prepare it properly. So it will absorb and enhance any of the flavors that are around it. So you can prepare it ahead of time and make it serve it cold, or you can serve it hot like I'm doing now. It's really a good vegetable to use with a multiple of different ingredients with it. So here it goes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's the way it should taste. So I can still taste the squash, but it's got a sweetness to it that it's just not squash taste. And the butteriness, it makes it like melty smooth in my mouth. So you can see it's still a little bit steamy. Really good. So I hope you enjoyed. This is my first attempt at Eric's kitchen. So those of you who I've been lucky enough to have over and enjoyed your company, I like cooking for you. So this is just one example of combining a bunch of ingredients that I had in the refrigerator. I had a lot of vegetables. I had a little bit of bourbon. Makes a meal go much better. Normally I would serve it with some wine. So if you've been over to my house, I've enjoyed your company, and it just makes it so much better whenever we have a good food and we have a good time. Wine makes it much better. So anyway, I enjoyed this. Hopefully you will too. So I'm always willing to learn, so feel free to give me your suggestions as well. Until next time.